Hey everyone, today I'm going to go through HubSpot's sales extension in Gmail, and we can actually install this for Gmail or Outlook, and today I'm going to focus on Gmail. Basically what this is a little plugin, a little extension you can have in Chrome, and you can also connect directly up to Gmail that allows you to keep track of your emails that you're sending in Gmail and automatically saving them in HubSpot, both the email you send out to your customer or lead or prospect and the reply that they hopefully will send you. You can see here that it looks just like this when it's installed. Some of the functionality you can see includes the ability to have templates and meeting scheduler. Some of these features you need to upgrade to the Sales Hub Pro to get, but we'll go through those in another video. But just to give you sort of a quick intro, there's templates, meetings, tasks. You can do sequences like little mini automations. Snippets are like little pieces of little templates, and then attach documents, which you can also, it's not really attaching it, but it's like creating a link, and then the user can then look through the document and you can see which pages and how much time they've spent on certain pages, and even if they've opened the document. And you can use that to trigger automations and workflows in HubSpot as well. So I really like the templates feature and the meetings feature. So I'll definitely go through them in another video to show you a bit more. But for today's video, we're going to talk about how to install this extension and getting it set up correctly. So we'll start there because that's obviously the best place to start. And then you'll be able to keep track. You'll be able to log all the emails, track whether they've been opened, and all these other little bits of functionality. The other great thing is when you start writing an email, you can turn on the extension over here in Gmail. You can actually see information about this contact already. If you've already emailed them before and you have them in HubSpot, you can look up details about the contact, the company they're from, the timeline of communication with that contact, any deals you've got, and the status, tasks that you've got set for that contact, all in this one place. And you can easily click and open the contact in HubSpot as well. So that's the main benefits of installing this extension. I'd say it's a must have. If you're using HubSpot, even the free version of HubSpot, I think it's great to install this extension. So you should do so if you haven't done so already. Let's jump into how to install it. So we start by going into settings in HubSpot. So you can see here, you click this little cog and go into settings. Under settings, you go into general and then email. And then you'll have this option here to connect your personal email. So you start by doing that. And it's great to turn on the inbox automation because that will utilize HubSpot's AI system to pull extra details from the email, including when you send out an email and you get a reply from your prospect, any details that's in their email signature, like their address and their phone number, et cetera, that, and job title, that potentially can be pulled into your HubSpot CRM automatically. And it has some other cool features as well. So definitely turn that on. Then we connect up the email. So let's just type that email in here. And we go next. We click connect to Gmail. It's already worked out that it's hosted by Gmail, so that's great. Connect to Gmail, click connect, allow, and then it's connected. And then we can also download the extension. So we click here to download the one for Gmail. Add to Chrome. And then we get this little pop-up. So set up to HubSpot Sales Extension. I'm not sure if this always appears. I haven't always seen this one, but we want to select all features so that we can track all the outgoing emails and log the various emails into the CRM. And then we can see here the HubSpot logo with the little green means it's connected like this. And we can also see the little pop-up like so. The extension's installed, the connection's made. And now if we wanted to adjust what emails we're tracking, for example, you don't want to log every single email you send from your Gmail account, you can click on log and track settings. We can turn off the defaults here if you want to, or you can turn them on. I would suggest leaving them turned on, and that way it'll automatically log and track each email. Otherwise, if you turn them off, you'll have to always remember to add it sort of manually. But you can add never log email addresses or domains. So let's say you didn't want to accidentally save an email that you sent to your accountant. You could add their email address in here. You could also add in email addresses for like expense systems or whatever. So basically anything being sent to like Expensify wouldn't be added here. Now these by default, if you're the admin for your account, you can see here that they'll apply to all users. But if you're an individual, you may only be able to add them for your particular setup like this. You may only have the option to block for you. But you can see here with the logo, by hovering over here, you can see who it applies to. So we can see here, if we click here, we can see the details for this contact, and everything else is set up, ready to use. So let me know what you think. Hopefully this has been useful. I'll be doing a couple of videos about the templates. I've already done a few videos about the meetings functionality in HubSpot, so you can check those out. And I'll also talk more about tasks in other areas in some future videos. So let me know what you think. Please feel free to share any comments. If you have them, any questions, I'd love to hear back from you. And also, if this video has been useful, please feel free to like it and subscribe if you want to get more content about HubSpot, Zapier, and other digital sales and marketing technology and software. So thanks very much for following along, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.